Now let's consider resistors and how they're made. A resistor limits current flow to safe values for components or reduces voltage to allow proper operation of circuits. As you've seen before, the symbol for a resistor is a jagged line, representing the fact that a resistor puts up an opposition to the flow of current. Let's take a look at how they're made. Carbon is the most commonly used material for resistors. There are several common types of fixed resistors. At first, most resistors were made of a simple carbon composition. At the core of these resistors are carbon granules, to which wire leads are attached. More carbon increases the conductivity and lowers the resistance value. An insulating material is used to coat the carbon for strength as well as insulation. Now the most common type of resistor is the carbon film type. A carbon film is deposited on an insulating form and then spiral cut around the form. The longer the strip cut by the spiral, the higher the resistance. For very high precision requirements, resistors are manufactured using a special metal film that doesn't change resistance as temperature changes, unlike carbon. As with carbon film resistors, the deposited film is cut, usually with lasers, to form the spiral ribbon of resistive material. A fourth common type of resistor is the wire-wound resistor, or power resistor. Such resistors are made using nichrome resistance wire, which allows high amounts of heat to be safely generated within the resistor. Resistors have two ratings, their resistance, of course, and their heat capacity. The heat capacity of a resistor is called its power rating. Generally speaking, the larger the size of the resistor, the higher the power rating. Typical power ratings are 1/4 watt, 1/2 watt, and 1 watt for low power resistors, while wire wound resistors are rated for 5 watts, 10 watts, 25 watts, or more. When designing electronic circuits, the heat or power generated in resistors must be considered. Otherwise, the results can be catastrophic. As a safety margin, engineers always select a resistor with a power rating twice the power to be generated in the resistor. In other words, if a resistor will actually consume 1/4 of a watt of power, a 1/2 watt resistor would be placed in the circuit. The ohmic value of a resistor, its resistance, is most often indicated using a color code system. There are a couple of reasons for this. The value could be printed on the body of the resistor, but some resistors are so small that you probably couldn't read the numbers. A second reason for the color rings is that since they go fully around the resistor's body, the value is visible no matter which way the resistor is mounted. There are normally 4 colored bands around a resistor. To interpret the color code, we need to know 2 things: what color represents what number, and how the 4 bands represent the number of ohms. Black represents 0, brown is 1, red is 2, orange is 3, yellow is 4, green is 5, blue is 6, violet is 7, gray is 8, and white is 9. To remember the color code, try using a phrase that has the first letter of each word represent the first letter of each color in order. Here's one for you. Bad boys run on your grass, but Violet and Greg won't. The colors going from black to white are bad, black, boys, brown, run, red, on, orange, your, yellow, grass, green, but, blue, violet, violet, Greg, gray, won't, white. Whenever you're working with resistors, it's a good idea to write down each letter and its number as you begin, so you don't have to think about it over and over. To read the value of a resistor, always begin with the color nearest the edge of the resistor. The first color band represents the first digit of the value. On this resistor, it is brown. Looking at our table of colors, we find that brown represents 1. So the first number of the resistor's value equals 1. The second band represents the second digit. Black, in this case, represents 0. The second number of the resistor's value equals 0. So the first 2 colors represent the first 2 digits of the resistor's value, 1, 0. Since the third band of this resistor is orange, and orange represents 3, you might think that the third digit of the resistor's value is a 3. In fact, only two digits are normally used to represent the value, with the third color representing a multiplier factor or number of digits. As a multiplier, the third color represents a power of 10. Since 10 to the third power is 1,000, or 1 kilo, as a multiplier, the first two digits would be multiplied by 1,000, or 1K, which equals a value of 10,000 ohms, or 10K ohms. Thinking of the third band as simply the number of zeros to add, the value would be read as brown representing 1, black representing 0, and orange for 3 zeros, giving us a value of 10,000 ohms, 10K ohms. Here's a similar resistor with the same first two bands, but the third band is also black. Since black represents 0, you might think that the third digit of the resistor's value is 0. But remember, only two digits are normally used to represent the value, with the third color representing a multiplier factor or number of zeros. Since the third band represents the number of zeros, black, representing 0, means to add 0 zeros. So the resistor's value would be simply 10 ohms. Now, what of the fourth color band on a resistor? It represents an accuracy factor or tolerance for the resistor. The tolerance band is most often silver or gold, with silver representing plus or minus 10% accuracy and gold representing plus or minus 5% accuracy. Our original resistor has a silver fourth band representing a plus or minus 10% accuracy. 10% of 10,000 means to multiply by 0.1, or move the decimal point one place to the left, giving a tolerance value of 1,000. The resistor's value could range from a high value of the color code value of 10,000 plus 1,000 ohms, 11,000 ohms, to a low value of 10,000 minus 1,000, 9,000 ohms. So our resistor, color-coded brown, black, orange, silver, has a value of 10,000 ohms with a 10% tolerance. Its value could range anywhere between 9,000 to 11,000 ohms and be within acceptable tolerance. Red, representing 2%, and brown for 1% accuracy are sometimes seen as tolerance bands, but they're unusual. Most often, highly precise resistors have their value directly stamped on them. No color code is used at all. This is particularly true of the highly precise metal film resistors. By the way, earlier we said to read the color code on resistors beginning with the color closest to its edge. Some resistors have their colors distributed evenly across the body. In this case, look for the tolerance band, virtually always silver or gold. Then work from the other end of the resistor.